everybody, welcome in. My name is Ernest and I'm gonna teach you how to cook today. It is a super quick dish. I know I've been saying that a lot lately, but they're really super quick dishes. And this one takes sausage and one of my favorite things, polenta, and blends it into a sausage polenta bake. It is so quick and delicious. I think you're gonna be making it all the time. Any extra helping, we've made polenta on the show before, but I'm gonna show you how to make it for this particular recipe. Not sure if you knew that polenta is actually pretty versatile, and we're gonna cover that in the extra helping, but let's get going. I've got stuff on the stove, and I've got an empty stomach. You don't wanna get between me and that, so let's get going. This is Eating in Bed. Probably safe to say that a lot of people love cornbread. You eat it with chili, you eat it with beans, you eat it with a lot of different things. And a lot of people love sausage and peppers. You put it on a nice crescent roll, or not a crescent roll, but some sort of Kaiser roll and have a great sandwich. You can serve it over rice or couscous or polenta. There is so many great things that I'm just dizzy today because we're doing sausage. I love pork product. I love bacon. We love bacon in this house. We love sausage. And my roommate loves to make sausage and peppers, and he makes up these delicious, just big skillets of stuff. I do mine a little differently, but today I'm blending the sausage and pepper idea with some baked polenta and putting it all together. And it's really an easy dish, and I think you're gonna make it pretty often. But right here in the pan, I have the equivalent of about a half of a white, really large onion, a white one. And I have one orange pepper. You can use yellow or red, whatever suits you. Green tends to be a little bitter, so I stay away from that. And I love the color of this. I cooked these down. There's a little bit of fond on the pan. That's okay. And here I have a pound of Italian sausage. This is sweet sausage. You can use hot sausage if you want to, or a blend of either one, but it's only 1 pound. This recipe easily doubles if you have a bigger family or a bigger dish, or want to do two dishes of it. Just keep the single recipe for each dish. So I'm gonna crumble the sausage into here because sometimes it's really gummy and it's hard to break up with your spoon just because of the nature of it. Now, when I started the peppers and onions, I only used 1 tablespoon of oil. That's why my pan is a little bit dry. You're gonna have some fat render out of this sausage, and you don't want the whole thing to be really greasy or oily. So hold back on the oil at first. This sausage will kind of reconstitute the whole thing with a little bit of fat, but we're still gonna strain it out of there so your casserole or your bake, as we're calling it, is not overly greasy. Now, you're not gonna cook the sausage all the way through. You're really just going to cook it until it's not totally raw. Because remember, this is going in an oven, and so you're not gonna have to cook it all the way. It's gonna cook a little bit more in your oven. While you're doing this, preheat your oven to 400 degrees Fahrenheit. We've made polenta on the show before, and it's really good. It's just cornmeal, stock, couple little extra ingredients to make it super yummy. But today I'm doing it a little bit different. When polenta cools down, it starts to solidify. You can actually use that in your favor. And I'm gonna show you how to make the polenta. You put it in the fridge overnight. You kind of want to make it a day ahead or early in the morning if you're using it for dinner. But if you don't have time to do that, you can totally buy the polenta that you see in the grocery store. It's usually in the produce section over by maybe where the tofu is or some of the vegetarian products or maybe some of the pre-cut fruit that they bowl up for you to buy just on a quick trip. You'll find it there, and it's usually in a 16 to 18 ounce tube. And you wanna take that, and be careful because there's some water in it. So cut the end off of it, drain the water out, and then cut the polenta. It comes in a long tube like sausage, like breakfast sausage. And you're gonna cut it in about 1/4 inch slices. Now for this recipe, I love everything as homemade as possible. So I actually made the polenta. And again, you'll see that in the extra helping. There's a couple extra things I put in there for the sake of this recipe. I got about 10 pieces out of it, and I used a cookie cutter. But if you don't have a cookie cutter or don't find anything you really want to use, once you plop that polenta out, you can just use your knife and cut about, you know, 2 to 2.5 inch squares to use for this recipe as well. Okay, so this isn't totally cooked. There is still some pink in here, but it's not totally raw either, and that's kind of what we want. But now I'm going to add 1 small jar of artichoke hearts in a marinade. You can find this on the ethnic aisle. You can probably find it on the pickle aisle. 1 6-ounce jar is 3/4 of a cup, and that's what you need. Drain off the brine and just give it a nice coarse chop on your cutting board. And we're gonna add this right to our dish. Interesting ingredient, right? Adds a nice pickly brine to it, but not overtly so, because that sausage is really savory and intense, and you want to break that a little bit, and this these artichoke hearts will really do that for you. Okay, so I'm just going to cook those about a minute, not very long, and then right at the end I need 2 cloves of garlic. You can press them or you can mince them really fine. Some people actually slice the garlic for this recipe. I'm not a huge fan of chunks of garlic like that. So I will take it in one of my garlic presses here and get them right into your dish. And you're only going to cook that for about 30 seconds until you can smell it. Garlic burns super quick. I've actually had friends who put garlic in first thing when they're cooking something. In 30 seconds it's black, and then they build a whole dish off of it. And I'm like, really? I can smell the garlic. So I'm going to take it off the heat, and now we're going to assemble our dish. So here I have my baking dish. It's about an 8x10 dish with curved edges. It's a little deeper, but you can use one that's a little bit more shallow if you want. You need a little bit of room. If you have just a regular square 8x10 or 8x11 dish, that is perfectly fine. You could actually do this in 2 smaller dishes as well if you wanted to. So what I'm going to do is I have my polenta back here behind my bowl. This is what I cut. You'll see this in the extra helping. This was the lines from the parchment paper. This was actually the top of it. You can see the pepper and red pepper flakes in there. It's really tasty. Polenta is really versatile. Just because it goes cold doesn't mean it goes in the trash. So what we're going to do first is start with a little bit of our sausage mixture, which I have here. It's all nice and blended. Oh, that just smells so good. Put a little bit in the end of your pan, just like that. And then take a couple pieces of the polenta and stack them up. And then continue on. A little bit more. You're kind of bricking it here. It's a little bit slippery, so just work with it. You can tuck it in more in a minute. Get some sausage. Make sure you have an even amount of peppers and onions and those artichoke hearts. Look at that. And then take a couple more pieces of polenta. Stack them across there just like that. And continue on. Remember, your sausage is a little bit raw, and that's okay, because this is going in a 400 degree oven for a little while, and it'll cook in there just fine. Add a little bit more sausage here. I want to make sure it's all even in ratio. Couple more pieces of polenta. I'm doing about 3 per row in my dish. Depends on your dish, you might use a little bit more. I've got 2 left, which is great. I had some of those odd pieces left over when I finished as well. So you could just kind of put those scraps and any leftover sausage you have in another dish and finish that off. Look at this. I'm gonna take these last 2 pieces, just kind of tuck them in right there. I told you this was easy. And now I'm just gonna add 1/3 of a cup of shrimp stock. You can actually use chicken or beef stock for this, but I had some leftover shrimp, so that's what I'm putting in here. So that's how you combine this. This is really quick already, even though I kind of had a head start on the onions before we started filming. You're gonna cook those onions maybe 5 or 6 minutes with the peppers, then start layering in the sausage, maybe another 5 minutes. You're gonna cook this off at 400 degrees for about 20 to 25 minutes. The top will get nice and browned and crispy, and then we're gonna top it with a couple of things at the very end. Stay tuned, because in the extra helping, I'm gonna show you again how to make a really good polenta and how to make these little circles, because polenta is really soft and yummy like a porridge. How do I get them like this? Stay tuned, the extra helping is gonna tell you. I'll see you right after this.
Pillsbury Crescent Rolls make an ordinary dinner extraordinary.
Oh, that hot and fresh dough.
What's baking?
Baking up hot.
Pillsbury Crescent Rolls.
Baking up so, oh, so light and flaky, so buttery tasty, oh.
Pass those hot, tender, flaky crescent rolls, please.
oh, poppy fresh dough.
We'll be right back.
In a large Dutch oven over a medium-high heat, add 4 cups of chicken stock. Homemade is best for this. Then mince or press 2 cloves of garlic. You're gonna need about 2 teaspoons. Put that right in the stock. Bring the stock to a boil. Once it's at a boil, slowly whisk in 1 cup of cornmeal. Take a little at a time, constantly whisking. If you go too fast, you'll get lumps. This assures that you're gonna have a nice, smooth polenta. Once it's incorporated, switch to a wood spoon and stir the polenta almost constantly for 10 minutes. Scrape the bottom of the pan so you make sure it's not sticking. About halfway through, add 1 tablespoon of kosher salt and 1 teaspoon of black pepper and a pinch of red pepper flakes. Continue stirring until your 10 minutes is up. After 10 minutes, turn the heat off, add 1 cup of freshly grated Parmesan cheese, 1/4 cup of creme fraiche or a good sour cream. You can use cream cheese if you wish, and 1 to 2 tablespoons of unsalted room temperature butter. With your wooden spoon, stir all that in. The polenta will become nice and creamy. The cheese will melt along with the creme fraiche and the butter. Next, line a 9x13 pan with a piece of parchment paper on the bottom. You can put a little cooking spray in it, but it's not really necessary. Use a spatula and scrape all of the polenta into the dish. You have to do this while it's hot, so be careful, don't burn yourself. Use your spatula and smooth out the polenta in the baking dish. Next, just put the baking dish in the fridge at least 6 hours. Overnight is better. After the polenta has totally chilled, use a butter knife or an offset spatula to loosen up the edges. Quickly turn it out onto a cutting board. Be quick about it, but it should come right out. Peel the parchment paper off. Use a cookie cutter or the rim of a glass to cut out circles from the polenta. Make sure you start right at the edges. You should get about 10 discs. You can also just use a knife and cut this into about 2.5 or 3 inch squares. Now your polenta is ready for our sausage bake. Okay, it's been about 25 minutes. I've pulled this out of the oven. I want you to take a look at this. Look how yummy that looks. It's all nice and brown and crispy on top. But it's still nice and soft and tender, those polenta pieces. You can't go wrong with this. Now, a couple of things we're going to add right to the end of this. I've chopped about 1/4 cup of parsley, and you want to put a good little bit over the top. That adds just some nice greenery. It adds a nice bit of freshness to it. Just evenly all around. And then, for a little bit of acidity, a lemon. I cut just the tip off of a lemon, the end of it, and then just do a light squeeze right over the top. Not a lot, but you can add more if you want to. And then a little Parmesan cheese, some freshly grated Parmesan cheese. Asiago would be great on this. You just can't beat it. Anything that's good. Now to serve this, it's pretty easy. You're just gonna spoon this out. I've got a plate here. Just really want to taste it, but just spoon out kind of with the portion of the and your polenta is going to break apart, but actually if you can turn it over and put the sausage on top of it, scoop down in there. Look at that, just a lot of great flavor in a very small area. I mean, that's, you know, big things come in little packages. Let's give this a try. It's nice and hot, so be careful. Look at that. It's a nice, that polenta, you know, is really firm when it cools down, but when you're cooking it, it softens back up again, but it still has some shape to it. That is so good in so many ways. It's savory from the sausage. The polenta kind of melts and falls apart the way that polenta normally does when it's nice and warm. Those peppers and onion, ooh, and that little bit of lemon and parsley all add different levels of flavor to all of this. Let me try one of the peppers here. By themselves. That's really good stuff. So I want you to try this. Leave me a comment below and let me know how much you love it. Click the like button, give it a thumbs up if you would, and hit subscribe so you don't miss a thing. I appreciate you watching, and I wanted to say hello to Delaney. How you doing? And I'll see you all next time. Thanks for watching. Bye.